we ain't into fish, then we're hitting the road. I live the life of a fisherman that never gets old. So welcome to the show. Come on, yo, we're going ice.
You know, when we were planning the new season of Going Ike, there was one show that I had to do. I call it Cajun bassing. You know, fishing in Louisiana, in the swamps, in Cajun country. You know, an opportunity to fish with a good friend of mine, Cliff Crochet, AKA Cajun Baby.
Cliff Crochet, born and raised Pierre Port, Louisiana, Bassmaster Elite Series Pro.
There's something about that style of fishing and that lifestyle. I've been attracted to it. You know, from where I'm from, growing up near Philadelphia, there's cars and traffic and people, and you don't see that at home at all. And that's awesome. I want to ride one of those. Can I ride one of those in a little bit?
Just living here is simple, it's slow. You're on the water. You know just about everybody. If you don't know everybody, you know somebody who knows them. Everybody's one person away. I mean, why would you leave? It's perfect, absolutely perfect.
Not only did I kind of break through from the Federation to the pro ranks in Louisiana, but I also won my Bassmaster Classic in 2003 in Louisiana. So this is a really special place for me, but man, I'm nervous. Literally a couple days before we're going to film this show, a huge Arctic blast coming down all the way from Canada. I'm on the fence about whether we're going to be on the right side of this cold front or on the left side, and you know, it's gonna make or break this show. You know, I met Cliff in the morning, it's a little gas station, and we talked about our game plan a little bit.
If we can catch it pre-frost, you know, before it blows through and gets real cold, and bluebird, that's what I wait for.
Cloudy and rainy's okay.
Yeah.
Three things I've gotta watch out for today on the river.
Three things you gotta watch out for. One is a jumping carp. You catch an Asian carp in the face, you're probably going to the hospital. Two, gotta watch for stumps. Three, sandbar problem. My biggest fear was riding with you. So that's why I'm driving the bull.
Right.
I drive the bull. I'm not riding with you.
You don't want to be in the trees today?
Absolutely not.
So what? I put it up in the woods one time. Hit a concrete dock one time. You know, big deal. I stuffed a couple 12-foot waves over the years.
Never in my life have I willingly given my boat up. But I trust this guy. So I'm going to give it to him. You got my keys today.
You trust me or you got no choice? One of the two.
I gotta give him credit for that. He knows this area. He's grown up here. I mean, literally, he knows every single corner.
I won a Bassmaster Central Open fishing in the basin about a month ago to take care of my people and my family and let them see it and to qualify for the Classic. To do it on my home water where I had grew up, it was one of the best days of my life.
54 degrees. Feels like 54, overcast, potential 40-mile-an-hour gusts. We got a warning. Wind, north-northeast, 20, 25, with gust near 30. Woo!
Crazy. Freaking Yankee in a swamp. Hopefully, I'll make it out of line.
I mean, the barometer is falling. You know, when I'm sitting there and I'm talking to Cliff, we're like, dude, on paper, this is exactly what you wanted. You couldn't have scripted a better day to go after bass. But until you get there and until things start happening, you really don't know what's happening.
Right, our starting spot, man. I'm stoked. First thing I noticed, bro, water's clean.
Good water, got some bait jumping. Got a front moving through them. I'm thinking it's a perfect storm. I hope it is.
All right, start out with some moving baits.
Yeah, that's the plan. Spinner bait, chatter bait, rattle trap. Should be able to catch them just whining and fishing and catch them and not really hoping we ain't really got a fish for them, but we can just catch them.
All right, let's do it.
Oh, we see a little piece of hydrilla out there, huh?
Yeah. And it,
oh. Yeah, bite?
Look,
oh, my
ball.
God! Quick. Put it back. Bro, that was way out in the middle.
Yeah, any kind of grass, anything. Especially when we get kind of up. See how they got them little flats? We got a little flat rider, got a little flat up there. Anywhere on the edge of them little flats where they got scattered grass?
Yeah.
That could be one.
Let me ask you this. We've had three bites. We haven't hooked one yet. Why?
Rusty. Rusty.
Rusty.
I'm after a Cajun bass today, Cliff. Number one, and it's a giant. And let me tell you something. On my home river, if you catch this bass right now,
I'd be pumped up.
You're pumped up.
Yeah.
Bro. Yeah, little thing, you got shoulders.
Right at that very moment, I kind of knew that this day had the potential to be one of those special days. You know, Cliff's throwing a spinner bait. I'm throwing a vibration jig.
Oh God. Something is wrong with this chat. Look at the size of the boil behind it.
And we're getting a lot of bites, but they're not all eating the bait.
I mean, I wonder if that first one was too, because they're definitely not eating it like a bass. They're like swapping at it. There you go. Big one too. That's a bass.
Yeah, that's a chunk.
Yeah. Cajun bass, baby. That was a bass. I threw right back in that same spot and he ate it again. It's funny the way they're hitting it. Well, that's a better one. That's a keeper. Nice one.
We would be leading on the Delaware right now.
We'd be.
Ah, that was a...
Want to eat it?
Yeah.
You know, we've got the perfect conditions out here to fish these power baits, spinner baits, vibration baits, and you'd think they'd be gobbling it. And a lot of the bites we're getting are slapping at it. We just had one right there. They're slapping at it. We've had a couple hooked outside the mouth. It's really strange, you know, why they're not gobbling it.
Uh-oh, there's a big one. Oh, the big one. I mean, a big one, bro. Oh, God. Stay on there. Oh, God, stay on there, you sucker. God.
Yeah! He got outside the mic.
Look at that, too. Look at that thing. Bro, switch that spinner bait. You were right. Molix.
That's a good one, bro.
Yeah, that's 3-pounder.
How long that fish is. Look how pretty they are, dude.
When fish are biting or slapping at it and they're not getting it, that's telling you that you've got to tweak it and you've got to change and you've got to keep adjusting to that puzzle.
Secret bait of the pros right there, folks. Oh.
Ah. Small one.
That was your first cast. Oh my God. Wow.
God.
Dude, smoke. God, it's crazy, bro. You saw that, right?
Mm-hmm.
I gotta go to square bill. I gotta go to square bill. I'm just thinking because, you know, with something with treble hooks on it.
You snag them a little bit.
Yeah.
And they should be biting it, you know, in the back of their throats, but we're missing them. But that ended up being kind of a cool deal because we kind of had to tank and play with retrieves and baits.
We really started to figure out the pieces of the puzzle.
Oh, God! Oh, my God! Giant, bro!
And as we go up this canal, we're figuring out these key elements.
Anytime you see the grass, isolated grass that comes further off the bank, you've got to throw at that. Another key element is anywhere where there's a little gut or a drain that dumps out into this bayou, you got to cast in front of it. And then bait color starts to be the element. You know, I went from a black and blue vibration jig to a shad colored bait. You know, the whites, the shads, the colors that are really popping. Cliff picks up a gold rogue.
That bait plays when that water temp gets about 65 or below.
This slow in your face retrieve. And then he starts catching some good ones.
Whoa, bro, that's a big one. I can't even get my hands around it.
A little chunk.
Look at that thing.
Yeah.
Wow.
Chunk. Yep. Gros poisson.
Gros poisson.
Gros poisson. Big fish. Gros is big. Poisson is fish. The gros poisson. That's
gros
what we
poisson.
Like.
There we go.
That's a big one too. That is a big one too. Good one.
Yeah, so of course when you catch one fun fishing, you got all three trebles in him. Can't come undone no matter what. So what you do is you take brand new ones, shiny ones, expensive hooks, put them on there, you get one little hook in him, he comes off. I just love fishing when things like that happen.
Based off of that, I decide to start killing my vibration jig. You know, literally pulling it up, letting it fall on a slack line, just kind of like that rogue was doing, staying in their face.
Should, there you got him.
Look at this. Oh, he's got lipstick on. He got lipstick.
Get the London look.
I think I got a little something figured here, though.
Dropping it?
Yeah. That last bite before that clued me in, because I turned my head. I just stopped reeling it. Turned my head to look back and see if the poles were up.
Bam.
And that one hit, I mean, dead pause. Like on the fall, it hit it. You know what I mean? Like your line just, thump, like yeah. A jig bite. Another one. One full, big one too. Go, God! Oh my God, giant, bro! Don't you come off. Oh my God! Gone. Gone.
I got a figure now, bro.
And this is going on at the same time.
We like fishing in the bayou.
I catch that thing, letting the bait drop, letting it fall, almost fishing it like a jig. And look at where that bait's at. All morning we've been catching them outside the mouth, missing bites. And it's funny how just a little tiny retrieve difference a lot of times when you get dialed in. You know, we were talking about it all morning. We felt like we were close, but we weren't dialed. So this, hopefully, keep my fingers crossed, might be the deal.
Oh God! Dude, bro, you got smoked. That's a good one. Yeah! That is a giant, bro.
Caught me by surprise.
Not
wow,
even attention. Look at the color on that thing.
He's pretty. Zach, look how short, look how fat, like,
dude.
He's not long.
No, but he's, look how thick across he is.
Yeah, ça c'est bon.
Ça c'est bon?
Ça c'est bon.
And you said ça c'est... Ça c'est bon!
Ça c'est bon!
Ça c'est bon! No, that's not ça c'est bon. What's ça c'est bon?
Ça c'est bon is French for that's good.
That's good?
That's good.
All right.
C'est bon? Ça c'est bon.
What's that's bad?
C'est bon is like I'm asking you. C'est bon? That's good?
Yeah.
But if I say ça c'est bon, like I'm telling you,
right.
That's good. Bon,
okay.
That's good.
Ça c'est bon. I gotta be honest with you, having a really hard time understanding a lot of what Cliff's saying. You know, I don't know, man, all these tons and bouton and satin, I do a lot of head nodding. I shake my head yes a lot because I really have no idea what he's talking about.
Sloan, okay. Trenas, a coulée, that's all I was saying. A goo.
A goo?
A goo.
What's a goo?
That's a drum.
A drum?
Yeah.
Okay.
A flotton.
A flotton. I don't know.
Gotta get back for it. Oh God, that's a big one, bro. Or bigger.
That's a little chunk.
Gone, again. Gone, gone, gone. I mean, this day has went so perfect. I'm almost scared about what's gonna happen the rest of the day. You know, at that point, with the day going perfect, we decide to make a move, and we're going to go to a different part of this system that has more hardcover.
Step up to Exmark, the mowers that have been beautifying landscapes for more than three decades, featuring high-performance zero-turn riders like the new Exmark Radius, starting at just $49.99. With any Exmark, you'll get a great-looking cut in less time every time. That's why landscape pros purchase Exmark 2-to-1 over the next best-selling brand. So what are you waiting for? Put an Exmark to work on your property. Find your local dealer or request a free demo today at wearexmark.com.
So we make this area change, a windy slough that's got some deep water and cypress trees. And that, when I'm in Louisiana, is one of my favorite ways to fish. I like to put a big jig in my hand and flip those trees. And when they bite, you can crack them. Immediately, we start catching them.
Mini flip in his face.
Just a black and blue half ounce missile mini flip. Little chigger chunk on the back. And
there hasn't been a single problem. All the equipment's worked. We've caught like 30 fish. We've got five that weigh 18 pounds. Bro, it doesn't get any better than this.
But dude, that's a good, I don't care where you are in the country, that's a hellacious stringer of fish.
The other cool thing about this shoot, it's being immersed into the culture, Cajun Louisiana. To be able to do that with probably the best tour guide in the world, man, he showed us around where he grew up, and it was awesome. Took us to the tackle store he used to hang out, and of course we got to eat some of the food, that Cajun cooking. God took us to his mom's house and got to see some of the early stuff from his career. Man, so cool to see some of those trophies and plaques from when he was cutting his teeth.
That is unbelievable, man.
When I think of this part of Louisiana, I think of these boats.
You can't break it. You can build it however you want it. We did everything out of them, from fishing to hunting to commercial fishing, boat riding, whatever. It was all done out of one boat.
What the heck is that thing on the back? What is this thing?
That's a gold devil.
It's a gold devil?
Gold devil. Bug motor.
How much water can you run in this boat?
None. As long as
on dry land.
Well, as long as it's slop.
Slop.
Slop mud, you can run. Water probably, you know, an inch or two.
This to me is, I want to run this boat right now.
We can?
I want to go run this boat right now.
Wanna go jump something?
Yeah.
Beaver dams? We're going joyride in the swamp.
Joyride.
In
the swamp?
Yeah, just cruising around.
In the go devil?
In the go devil.
Now, I let you drive yesterday. Are you gonna let me drive this today?
Maybe.
I got a maybe.
Oh no.
I gotta tell you, I know this seems kind of strange to you. That's one of the coolest things I ever did right there.
You like that?
Dude, I liked it a lot. Now listen to me. Call me a Yankee all the time. And I am a Yankee. But after spending 2 days, I rode the Go Devil. I'm a little bit, can you just give me a little bit of Cajun now?
I give you a little bit. You're not as Yankee as you seem. As the address says. I give you a little more.
Yes! I'm Cajun! Woo! Oh my God.
I tell you, when I look back on this show, I'm gonna look back on it as one of the best shoots ever with a really good friend. But I tell you, Cajun bassing, fishing in this part of Louisiana, there's nothing like it. And I promise you, I'm gonna be back and do it again.
For information on the product and gear used in the show, go to MikeIaconelli.com and follow me on my social feeds at MikeIaconelli. And if you want to help grow the sport of fishing, get kids involved. Go to theikefoundation.org to figure out information on how you could help get involved in getting kids fishing.
Welcome to Bass University TV, an online video training course where you'll learn champion bass fishing techniques from pro anglers Pete Gluzek, Mike Iaconelli, and their talented special guests. From on the water to in the classroom, you'll learn sound techniques and strong fundamental bass fishing skills. Watch hours of video content on multiple topics at your own pace for a low monthly fee. Cancel at any time. Information is power in the sport of fishing, so learn from the very best. Subscribe to Bass University TV today.